Research has revealed almost half of young adults in the West Midlands thinks that social media puts an overwhelming pressure on them. We'll speak to a Kenilworth mom in just a moment, but the report from the Prince's Trust has found that sites such as Instagram, Snapchat and Facebook make 16 to 25 year olds feel inadequate and lacking in comparison to their friends. Tony's tweeted to say, to blame social media for behaviour is too simplistic. It's individual responsibility. I would imagine those young people know what life is all about and don't need to be comparing their bodies with somebody else. But let's speak to Vicky Shanks now, a Kenilworth mum to 7 children between the ages 18 and 27. Vicky, how come you look so young?
I wish I did.
You do. There's no grey hairs. You've got a flattish stomach. What's going on, you lucky woman? You're blessed with the right genes. But, you know, have you found this overwhelming pressure on young people because of social media?
Yeah, I do agree with that. And I think there is an overwhelming pressure. But I think we've progressed so far, so rapidly, that we haven't kept up with it. And I think as human beings, we're not equipped to keep up with technology moving at that rate. So what we're dealing with now is a totally different way of bringing our children up to the way it was 20 years or 30 years ago, 40 years ago.
So are your children like mine, literally addicted to their smartphones and their iPads?
They used to be. They're better now. As they've got older, they've actually got better, and they do it and they're on it, but they use it more as a communication device for their friends, so they're not so much on social media.
So they're not doing that sort of thing, that picture that a lot of them do, where they've got a picture of them in the mirror and they're taking a picture. You know, you can see them with their phone in their hand, but you can see their image in the mirror. You know what I mean? The pouty shots. They're not doing the pouty shots.
No, not so much now. I mean, they've all been through that phase, but no, they don't do that so much. But I think this thing of comparing yourself, and the issue about that is that we all carry a pocket computer around these days, and I think we call it a phone, and actually we need to recognise it's a computer that gives us access to absolutely anything. And the problem is, when people put things up about their lives, they're putting the highlights up. They're not putting the nasty bits, the bits that go wrong and the bits where they're crying.
So you're a mum of 7. How have you managed to make sure it seems that they're well-informed and well-adjusted young adults?
Do you know, I've never, ever, ever pried into their phones or their laptops, ever. And the reason I haven't done that is because I've wanted them to have complete 100% trust in me. Mm. And what has happened because of that is they now come to me with problems because they trust me. Now, their father, who died a number of years ago, through their phones, and it caused enormous problems. And I suppose what I've done is I've made them take an element of self-responsibility, but at the same time, given them an environment where they can trust me enough to come and talk to me about things they're worried about.
Sorry to hear about your partner, but I must admit, I'm a bit like him. I want to know what my sons are on because, you know, they just spend so much time on the phones. My other half is like a bit like you. Oh, leave them alone. They'll come to you when they want. But it's so difficult because we're hearing, you know, even last week about the self-harming images, which led to the 14-year-old Molly taking her own life and many more. So, you know, they're exposed to such dreadful images, aren't they, in many cases?
And they are. And I think, you know, we all have access to parental controls on the internet as parents. And I think more of us should utilise those. And I think another problem with computers and iPads and game stations, etc., is that parents more and more use those as babysitters rather than interacting with their children and talking to them and learning about them and understanding what their problems are.
And that's my fault, I think. Honestly, Vicky, I think years ago when I was stressed, I'd just give them an iPad, you know, just get on with it. And now I realise that I've opened up Pandora's box. So come on, mum of 7, you've been there looking great. What advice would you give to people listening, thinking, I'm just worried about my child or grandchild spending far too much time on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook? What advice would you give this?
I would utilise the filters. I would limit the time they have.
But then don't you get mardy teenagers?
Well, tough. I mean, the thing is, you either put the time in and create that relationship or you have the problems later on. It's up to you as a parent. But I think we shouldn't sideline the benefits of the internet, because a lot of people would have no relationships if it wasn't for social media. Right. So we have huge benefits from it as well.
Okay.
It's how we police it and how we teach our children to handle it.
Vicky, you've inspired me this morning, even with your flat stomach. I can't believe it. I look like the one that's had 7 kids, not
you. Bless you, you're fabulous.
No, it's all Spanx. Thank you very much, Vicky Shanks. You're looking incredible. I will put the picture of you on Facebook later on. Off here I go, social media. Thank you very much for coming
in. Thank you, Trish.
It's lovely to meet you. 25 minutes past 8. Now, can you believe this?